Hey everyone, it's Sarah from slimdownwithsarah.com. Hello coaches, hello potential coaches, customers, whoever's watching. Okay, so today the topic is, if you are a Beachbody coach, how do you find customers? It's the most asked question ever of any coach. How do you find customers? Many of you should already know that when I first became a Beachbody coach, I had the same questions. I was like, how am I going to even find customers? I didn't go to my upline coach or my sponsor coach to ask for help. I just was kind of like, I'm going to figure this out. And I didn't look for customers at all. Like, at all. I simply started my journey and I filmed myself on YouTube. I made my slimdownwithsarah.com site and I let it go. I said, if someone needs help to lose weight, they're going to see this, you know, before and after. They're going to see that I'm doing Slim in Six, or they're going to see that I'm eating this way and doing Shakeology on a YouTube video, and they're going to find me. I hope. Like, I hoped. I think it took maybe 2 weeks to get my first customer, and I was so excited. I was through the roof. They actually emailed me, because at the time I did not have any other way of contacting me. I just would simply put, if you need my help, you know, find me at this email and we'll chat. And that's exactly what I did. And I actually made a sale. That was my very first customer. And after that, it just slowly started to build after that. And I want to say probably about a year and a half into that, of making videos, because as you can see, if you've never watched my vlogs on YouTube, you just gotta search Slim Down with Sarah or Mama Hass, and you will see hundreds of workout videos amongst every other kind of video. I have videos of everything. And I just put my life out there. I don't know why I felt the need to, I just kind of wanted to. And I never expected anything out of it, but I'm glad that I got customers that way. And it really wasn't hard. Like, I was nervous making videos in the beginning, but now, as you see, I'm really, it's just like every other day. Like, I just can talk my, I can talk your ear off on, on film. So anyways, that is really how I got started. I can honestly say, that's my dog, because someone said in one of my videos, they're like, is your dog scratching out the dirt? No, it's my dog actually walking on my floor, and that's my other dog barking probably at the wind blowing, so ignore that. Anyways, I honestly can say that I never really go out and search for customers. I made it so people would want to talk to me through my personal experiences. Just like you see on TV, you know, if you see someone who has lost weight, or if you see someone who is singing and you want to learn more about them because you love their music, you go online and you find out more about them. So that's why I made my slimdownwithsarah.com page. I wanted there to be like a little hub where somebody could go and find out all about me, how I lost my weight, what programs I did, pictures of before and afters, where to go to get the products, you know, how to contact me. Like, I wanted someone to be able to just get all this information in one spot. And I think that has made it a lot easier for me to find customers, because not only can they find everything about me if they really want to, they can actually contact me and then talk with me one-on-one. So like I said, a year and a half later, I made my fan page, so I no longer had to sit there and answer the same email 100 times in a row, because, you know, you get asked the same question over and over and over and over again. So I was like, well, where can I find like a central location that I could post things daily and help out my customers and also speak with them one-on-one if they have social media accounts as well? And that was Facebook. So then I opened my Facebook fan page up, and I really think that that helped me. I just took on to Facebook. I don't understand Twitter, but some of you may. Instagram is just hard for me. I don't know. Like, I'm just not good with Instagram. I'm good with Facebook, but your strong points might be in another social media website. So, you know, that's, I just find it easier to be able to quick, you know, answer something like that instead of, I feel like emails just take forever, but I do email. if someone doesn't have another account where I could reach them. So I feel like if I could give any advice, that's what you all should be doing as coaches. You want to put yourself out there to make it easier for people to find you. So this can go back, you know, all the way back to the video that I just posted about consistency. Like, if you're not consistent, then people aren't going to want to search for you because you aren't really saying anything that exciting. They're going to want to see if you're going to do YouTube videos. They're going to want to see at least, oh my gosh, I think I was posting a video a day. Time consuming, right? But hey, this is a job, and if you want to be successful, you've got to work in the beginning in order to reap the benefits at the end. That's what I did. Now I can kind of, you know, relax on the videos because I have so many videos of me doing Insanity, Turbo Fire, T25, Pio. You know, I have videos of me doing every single workout like 100 times. So people can see me through the different stages in my weight loss journey, how big I was then, how big I was here, how fast did I lose this weight. Like, they can see so many before and after. They just can find so much information about me and about what I do. So you have to be consistent with posts and such like that, so people can find you. I really don't recommend friends and family, because I found out that friends and family are the worst customers. Like, they want everything for free. And that's just not allowed. You just can't do that. And for some people, it is great, you know, because you might have a sister or a brother or whoever, or a cousin who's like, hey, let's start this business together. If you do, awesome. Do it that way, you know. But I don't have any family members that actually buy from me or that are coaches underneath me. But if you do have a spouse or something like that, my husband is just busy, you know, doing his own thing. In his career, he really doesn't have the time to commit, even though he's into fitness as well. But he just doesn't have the time to commit to being a coach, so that's kind of why he doesn't do it. But if your spouse is interested, that is the easiest way to, you know, start branching out to, you know, tap into coaches, which I'll get to that in another vlog. This is about customers. So, finding strangers and such, if you're not strong in social media, you need to be, what's the word I'm looking for, more outgoing, which I am not. I am not a good person to chat. Like, I feel like I'm bugging people if I talk about it in person, but you might not be like this. You might be like, well, I suck at social media, but I could talk your ear off about, you know, P90X because I've done it 3 times. If you are that person, you know, go get a P90X shirt in your back office and wear it. Wear it around, wear it anywhere, wear it to the grocery store, wear it to the mall. People are gonna come up to you and they're gonna ask you about it, you know. And then make sure you have a business card, pass it out to them. Pass out business cards, get customers that way. You know, there really is no magic way to get customers. You have to brainstorm. You guys have to do the work as a Beachbody coach. You are your business owner, and there's no one person that's going to give you the magic answer to be successful. Because if you go to one of those, you know, team building elite coaches, they're going to give you a script to read off of, and that's pretty much it. You know, they're going to tell you, this is how you sell a challenge pack and how you make your money back and blah, 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 blah. You know, they're not going to actually tell you. They're going to give you scripts that you all can find in your back office. It's just that simple. Like, there's no magic key word to tell you how to find customers. I'm just kind of, you know, throwing out suggestions and stuff like that. I mean, just the biggest success that I have had is to just put yourself out there in every way possible on social media. And if that's something that you're really not willing to do, then coaching just isn't for you. I mean, it's just that simple. Or maybe you need to become a team building coach. You know, that's kind of the way I look at it. Like, if you're not able to put yourself out there, you know, then why not be a team building coach? Because you'll make a lot of money doing that. Like, it's just not for me, but I could show you how to do that. So anyways, let me wrap this up. I hope that helped out a little bit. It was just my personal experience. Like I said, I'm more of an organic coach. I don't go by scripts or anything. So those are the ways that I reach customers, and I have been extremely successful. There is no magic place where I could say, you can dip into here and you're going to find all your customers there. you have to go find them, or they have to find you by what you're putting out there. I'll see you guys later.